Fred Film Radio, this is Niccolò Comotti here at the 74th edition of Venice Film Festival, and today I'm joined by two wonderful people. I'm here with Susanna Nicchiarelli and Trin Tirholm. Welcome.
Hi, thank you.
Hi.
So you're here with a very brave film that I had the pleasure to see this morning, and it's Nico 1988. I've got little time, but I want to ask you something. You actually managed to dissect an icon, and you made a kind of a new icon on her own, like, unknown years. And I think, as a director, maybe you felt the responsibility as well, the artistic drive to do something, you know, great, because we're talking about a great person and a great human being and a great artist. How difficult was it for you to actually manage to create the right pace, the right story, where you actually, you know, you got interested in which kind of side, and maybe you left something behind? I thought that maybe it was a very difficult process for you.
And well, my intention was not to tell the whole story, but to tell a part of the story in order to tell the whole. Mm-hmm. So, I wanted it to be universal. I wanted it to be the story of a woman, and of a woman that with maturity actually finds herself as an artist, as a mother. And that is why I didn't really, we tried with Trine never to imitate the real Nico, mm-hmm. or never to be blocked by reality, by the fact that it was a true story. We tried to invent, we tried to be free, the freest possible that we could, at the same time with the respect that is due to a true story.
Sure. And especially the work that maybe you did together to create this new, like, let's call it this new Nico, the Krista, actually. Let's call it Krista because it's the real, the actual name. I just wonder, especially for all the actors out there, the process that you put into, you know, the making of this incredible female character, which I was transfixed by it. And I was so captured by when you know, like, the silent moments as well as the loud moments, and I just wanted to see, as director and actor, what kind of process and method you put together.
Well, we met in Copenhagen, had a chat, and we clicked so well, so it was easy to work mm-hmm. together, and so I had a lot of trust in Susanna, because it is a complicated character, and we worked with the songs. We worked very physically, and I mean, I think that it was very inspiring, that journey up until actually we started shooting, because we used, like, I don't know how many days in the studio trying to find the voice, and we dyed my hair, and, you know, we found the wig, and of course talked about the script and her inner world, and so it was a long process, so yeah, it was a great collaboration.
Was a lot of the footage actually left behind, so the cut was like reduced, or you was
no.
scripted and you just kept it
to was very scripted. I mm-hmm. write very short films, and I like short films, and we didn't cut much. It's
yeah, I asked just because it's like the so many moments, you know, when you are in front of the camera are so real that I thought that it was almost like a patchwork of the realest moments.
No.
Maybe it's just you that is incredible.
No. Yeah. It was very scripted. There's, of course, together when we were preparing, Trine had a lot of ideas, and we had a lot of ideas together, but it wasn't at all the kind of film, the improvised film.
Well, guys, thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you.
And this is
thank
Fred
you.
Film Radio, the Festival Insider.
Fred Film Radio, 24/7 on fred.fm and smartphone apps.